I'm Mark Segreaves, and now we talk with Cyndi Glass and Steve Cline. Steve Cline is with the Partnership of Drug-Free America, and Cyndi Glass is a mother who lost her son to drugs and now is working to make sure it never happens to anyone else. Cyndi, we want to start with you because the event is really in honor of your son. Tell us about the event first, and then we'll talk a little bit about your son.
Okay, Jeremy's run is every Memorial Day. This is the sixth one, and it starts at 8 o'clock in the morning. And the purpose of the event, of course, is to honor the memory of my son, Jeremy. And we also want to raise awareness to the dangers of substance abuse. Our main goal is really to raise money for prevention and education, treatment and rehabilitation.
So let's back up a little bit and tell us just a little bit about your son's story.
Okay, Jeremy was a normal teenager. He was playing football for his high school, and he got tackled in his knee, and he pretty much shattered it, had to have three surgeries. And during that time, of which before this time he had never taken drugs, he swore to me he would never take drugs, drink, or smoke, he was introduced to Percocet, and he had three surgeries.
Now, these were prescription, obviously, because of the surgeries and everything very legitimate and doctors had prescribed for him.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, he really didn't need them.
Right.
But he also really loved them. And he started to look for them and buy them from people. And I started noticing his personality changing. And we were trying very hard to figure out what was going on. We took him to therapists. We had him in outpatient programs. And finally, we sent him away for his first inpatient treatment. He came back great. He was doing really well. And then he became non-compliant. And this happened four times. And from the time he was 15 until the time he was 20 is when he died. It just escalated and escalated. Every treatment we'd send him to, he'd come back and start using again and more until we found a needle in his room. And, you know, it was devastating to find that. And we said, you're either...
And this meant that he had graduated
from
prescription drugs
mm-hmm.
to heroin?
Mm-hmm.
You know, as a parent, I mean, you can only imagine what you must have gone through at this point. And it sounds like you tried everything that he even wanted to get better.
Yeah, he did want to get better. He did. He obviously couldn't.
And Steve, let me ask you, you look at this kind of from a global perspective, I guess, and how typical is this story?
Well, unfortunately, it's not atypical. I meet a lot of people who are in Cyndi's situation. Similar, everybody's different, but similar experiences. And I have to give her and everybody else I've met all the kudos in the world for taking something that is absolutely the ultimate tragedy and turning it into something that can benefit others.
A few tips do you have for parents, how they can either...
Well, we have a project we call the Medicine Abuse Project, and Cyndi's well aware of it, and one of our biggest supporters. And it's a website, medicineabuseproject.org. There's a pledge on there. I want every one of your viewers to take the pledge. It's real simple. It's saying, I'm going to take care of my medicine and I'm going to talk to my family about it. But taking care of it is you know, most of us of a certain age take medicine daily. And there's absolutely no problem with prescription medicine used as intended. It's a wonderful thing. The problem becomes when it isn't. And if your insurance company usually will give you a 90-day supply, are you going to miss it if two or three pills are? I mean, we're very serious about know what your medications are. You know, if you have to, lock them up. You know, it's a different world. Talk to your family about it. You know, make it a priority. You know, you said you have younger children. They should know about this. Cyndi was telling me she was talking to her five-year-old grandchildren about the difference between, you know, the good and the bad, if you will. So it's important. We need to get this on people's radar screens.
Cyndi, remind us all about Jeremy's Run, how people can get involved, when it's taking place and where.
Okay, it's in Olney, Maryland, And there's a 10K run, a 5K run, and a 5K walk, and a 1 mile fun run. And we have a website, www.jeremysrun.com, has all the details and online registration. The prices go up on May 1, so this is a really good time.
Beat the clock.
Beat the clock. And we've grown from 500 participants to, we're up to about 1,300 participants. And it's just a little grassroots operation, but it's a very important one.
And for a very good cause.